All the traditional and civic leaders present, the Superior General of the Religious Sisters of the Holy Spirit, Sister Rosaria, all religious superior generals and congregational leaders present, heads of institutions present, priests, religious sisters and brothers, and you all, my brothers and sisters. It is my humble privilege to be in your presence to address you all on this momentous occasion when we come together to celebrate the Golden Jubilee or the anniversary of the foundation of the Congregation of the Religious Sisters of the Holy Spirit. I do not take for granted this rare honor and privilege accorded to me. Your Lordship, all the clergy here present, ladies and gentlemen, allow me to begin by thanking the Almighty God for the gift of a gallant man, Right Reverend Bishop James Cowboy, S.J. May his soul rest in peace, who set up the Diocese of Monze and later founded the Institute of the Religious Sisters of the Holy Spirit, an inspiration we are celebrating today. I wish to acknowledge and thank the founder members of this great foundation who took courage to start the journey into the unpredictable future. We further applaud Ms. Rosemary Mudala, who is present here, and Ms. Romana Maumbu, also present here. I'm sure that all the sisters here agree that they are standing on the shoulders of all who came before them as a great foundation was built, as evidenced by where it stands 50 years after its birth. Your Lordship, the clergy, ladies and gentlemen, I want to recognize with much gratitude and amazement the contributions of the Religious Sisters of the Holy Spirit to the Church and the nation at large. Their presence and influence on education, health, social, and pastoral care sectors cannot be overrated. I look at their works with amazement because their input in any of their ministries should be done by a bigger team. It is evident that they continuously overstretch themselves selflessly to serve the needs of our people in the communities they serve. The commitment of our sisters has been tested over time, and I am witness to this positive attribute. Your Lordship, the clergy, ladies and gentlemen, I have been privileged to work with the Religious Sisters of the Holy Spirit on a personal level, and among the many attributes that they have, I wish to single out what I believe is rare but critical if we are to succeed. It is the gift of courage. These sisters do not fear to take on responsibility as long as there are people around them. Sisters, I do remember that you took over a huge task of managing Monze Mission Hospital at the time when only had two sisters to send in the healthcare facility. Additionally, you were taking over from a congregation that had much more resources than you did. That was a very remarkable act of faith. I also commend you for the way you integrated very well with the lay people who were on the management team. To date, Monze Mission Hospital is one of the most organized facilities with clear systems laid out. May the Lord God Almighty continue to bless you all. May our Mother Mary look upon you and seek for favors and blessing for you from the Almighty God. As it is in the name of your foundation, it is evident you are always filled by the Holy Spirit. Now, looking into the future, your Lordship, the clergy, ladies and gentlemen, may I, at this moment, specifically address the sisters in person and as a congregation. Number one, sisters, I encourage you to focus on growing your institute. You may reach out to the young people so that they can join you in order to increase the number of sisters in your institute. However, I must hasten to say that the quality of sisters you want to serve, you want to serve the world in future, should not be compromised. The church in the Western world is shrinking and mostly characterized by elderly populations. As such, everyone is looking to the church in the third world to provide the human resource that is needed. Therefore, my clarion call to you is to look for quality young people to join you and serve the communities diligently. Number two, may I also encourage you, sisters, to grab the new opportunities and to embrace new ways of serving the people of God. There is a lot that is going on in our world today, and you need to be updated and ahead sometimes in order for you to respond to real needs at the right time. Innovation and use of new technologies for communication, healthcare provision, and other community engagement that you are involved in is very key. Number three, furthermore, I challenge you, sisters, to be innovative as you redesign your ministries and plan the new ones. There are many lessons to learn on how to manage tough encounters when you review how the world has managed the challenges posed by the COVID-19. COVID-19 has taught us not to do business as usual, but to rise above the challenges and manage our responsibilities efficiently and effectively. Number four, I am reliably informed that you have embarked on a project to build a secondary school for both boys and girls at Nziva in Magoye, and that this school will have a unique feature in its approach to the curriculum, in that the school will put emphasis and structures to support eco-friendly integrated farming, as well as entrepreneurship literacy for its learners. I applaud that kind of innovation, because it will be an answer to forming young people to be successful entrepreneurs who can drive the economy of our nation. Number five, I am also aware that you have placed this celebration at the site where you intend to build a women's center. It is important that you ensure to design programs that are going to empower these local women with both skills and knowledge that they otherwise would have a chance to gain. As I conclude, I wish to encourage all of us gathered here to continuously support the church, and more so the religious sisters of the Holy Spirit. We all know that funding towards the church is a thing of the past, in order not to lose out on the gains made during these 50 years of service, we have to support and grow our church. Today, we are called to put resources in the basket for the use by the Religious Sisters of the Holy Spirit to manage its two projects they are embarking on. Remember, a gift is never too late. Allow me to leave you with a Bible verse for reflection. So then, as we have opportunity, let us do good to everyone, and especially to those who are of the household of faith. This is taken from Galatians chapter 6, verse 10. I wish you God's blessing in all your future endeavors. Thank you all, and God bless you.
Dr. Kaunda, for those encouraging words. Dr. Kaunda, I'm going to call you at a certain time to launch our album. I want to mention that the sisters took time to reflect on their life and sang their reflections. And the Jubilee Choir are going to sample to us what they sang. And these songs have been served on a flash disk, branded RSHS at 50. It is going at 120 kwacha each. It's a memory stick that still has space for some other things that you may want to save there. And the proceeds of the sale of the album are going towards the construction of this center that we have started. So we are all encouraged and requested to make this purchase. The music is definitely extremely beautiful. That this music was recorded, mixed, and mastered for us by Mr. Isaac Nsomokela from Lusaka. His media house is called Songs Media. As you can see, this album was sung by the Religious Sisters of the Holy Spirit and the Holy Spirit collaborators based in Monze. These are the Holy Spirit collaborators that live in Monze. We are going to share with you one of the reflections of one of the older sisters who was sharing with us what she saw, what she experienced, and we sang her reflection, and there we go.
Oh,
it is called in Zwisa. In Zwisa ngudionko. No, Jonko Tamani Nipe. Now, if you want to hear the full song, it is on the album. I now call upon the guest of honor to launch the album so that we begin buying Tatusova Nivia, Tandaguga Ulaga Flash, Kani Nivia, Turaga Mana. Dr. Kaunda, would you please come to the front so that you cut the ribbon for us and then we start buying the flash. Now, the next one, the sisters are recognizing those who helped, those who worked tirelessly to see to it that the congregation starts. And this is how it goes. Thank you. invite you. This is from His Holiness Pope Francis. His Holiness Pope Francis cordially imparts his apostolic blessing to the congregation of the religious sisters of the Holy Spirit on the happy occasion of the 50th anniversary of their foundation in Zambia. His Holiness prays that the sisters will find great joy and peace in their religious consecration to our Lord Jesus Christ, and that their life be of service in the church. Today we celebrate 50 years of our roots, our missionary presence and growth. It's been quite a journey. Unlike you, before I start my journey of thanksgiving, to observe with me a moment of silence, to remember all those men and women, religious and priests, who worked very closely with the RISHA, who would have loved to be here today, but have gone to the Lord. Bishop James Cowboy, Catherine Dunn, Sister Pierre Dullahan, Sister John Larison, Sister Trace English, Sister Sheila Morgan, Bishop Paul Lungu, Father Connie Han, Father Jordan Neal, Father Frank Kinnan, Father Frank Weffer, Brother Patrick Makeoda, Bishop Moses Hangbole, Father Dominic Nchete, Father Killian Chaila, to mention a few, and all our dear brothers and sisters, our benefactors and our parents. Can we just observe a minute of silence? Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let your perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. Amen. I deem it a great honor and privilege to stand before you after a fruitful and wonderful day of festivities, to say thank you on my behalf and that of all my RISHA sisters. As religious sisters of the Holy Spirit, we have seen the hand of God. And I believe everyone here has seen the hand of God at work. I give glory to God and thank Him for allowing all of us here to have survived the COVID-19 and be present here to celebrate today. Bishop Raymond Ntezele, I thank you, Bishop Raymond Ntezele, for accepting to come and celebrate with us. Your very presence among us here today, Bishop, is very significant because it reveals the growth of the church in the Diocese of Mwanza, Zambia. Thank you for your words of encouragement and for role modeling to us faith, humility, and perseverance. We are privileged to have you here today. You knew our founder, Bishop James Cowboy, and I hope what you have seen and heard at this gathering validates his dream. Father Peter Caro, thank you for all your words of encouragement.
and the insights you have shared with us today and over the years. Your guidance and skill of community dynamics enabled us as LRFS to get to know ourselves as individuals and as a group. You taught us how to speak our minds and be assertive wherever we are. To this day, as LRFS, that assertiveness makes us very daring because we are not afraid. You taught us courage and always bought into our founder's dream. The dream that we become communities of witness. We believe that it is in community that we live the essentials of our religious life. Your unwavering interest in us, your patience in those moments when we went silent for long moments in group sessions, that you never gave up on us. Thank you. Thank you for allowing one of our sisters to learn the skill from you, and she has become a great resource to persons information with, not only in our congregation, but even in other congregations. Thank you very much. Our guest of honor, Dr. Eugene Kaunda, thank you very much that despite your busy schedule, you found time to come and grace this occasion, even when you were approached at the last minute because Dr. Kaunda couldn't come. Thank you for delivering that speech in a very able way. And I want to thank you too for being a part of us and for the various ways you are managing and running Monze Hospital, and especially for managing the COVID situation this time very prudently and professionally. We are very proud of you and your team. Thank you very much. I know Dr. Mkonka is not here, but Dr. Mkonka is listening. He is listening to everything today in his house because his health is not very good, but he's listening. And to you, Dr. Mkonka, I would like to thank you. I would like to thank you for your words of encouragement, for the various ways and invaluable contributions you made in the running of Monze Hospital back then, but even up to now. We thank you for your unwavering hand that comes to us in the times whenever we call on you, and especially now for being our board chairperson. We have heard your talk, and we will surely focus on the growth of the Institute through reaching out to the young people and to the vulnerable in our work, so that we make the Holy Spirit known and loved in order to prolong the mission of Christ. COVID-19 has brought a new paradigm shift. The status quo has been shifted. It has been upset. We will encourage ourselves to always remain open to the promptings of the Holy Spirit so that we can see and be able to grab those new opportunities, redesign our ministries, and embrace new ways of serving the people of God, so that we can remain relevant to our time and our people. This is evident in some of the initiatives that we have gone into in the recent past. The construction of the Women's Center here, the foundation on which we are standing, the construction of the eco-friendly school in Mazabuka, our COVID electronic pastoral care program in Monzen Mission Hospital, and our idea of navigating and strengthening our collaborative links. To our founder members, allow me to take this moment to sincerely thank you, our founder members, for your admirable courage to venture into the unknown. It is on your shoulders that we stand today. Mrs. Rosemary Mudala Muyanga, Ms. Romana Maumbu, Sister Marcelina Hasbury, all present here, Sister Christetta Kaduko, gone to the Lord. Thank you very much for your courage. To the RISHN, we had a unique and special journey with you, our mothers. We thank you for working with us from the start to this day, for putting the RISH congregation first, fostering and accompanying our growth. We wish you God's blessing as you promote vocation in your own congregation. Thank you. For those who supported us in the beginning, all those men and women who played a pivotal role in our foundation and took care of us in various ways, the different congregations that harbored us in those years of our foundation, the congregations that Sister Marcelina mentioned, the Religious Sisters of Charity, the Sisters of St. Francis Maramba, Handmade Sisters, Sacred Heart Brothers, in whose house we live now, which is our novices. The Jesuits who gave us the land on which we have built our formation house, and all those who are still working with us to this day in various ways, and the Holy Ghost Fathers, we thank you, our collaborators. Thank you. To all our civic leaders, heads of institutions present here, thank you. I want also to thank our visitors, the Haywards, Jane and Jane, her daughter from Canada, who took time to come and celebrate with us. Thank you for coming. Many of our friends would have loved to be here today, but due to the pandemic, they could not physically be here, but are here with us watching online. To all of you, thank you very much for watching us and for working with us and sending us your anniversary greetings and your encouragement. Thank you very much. We have also received monetary and material support, both from abroad and here at home. These contributions have greatly eased our pressure of looking for resources and have made this day a success. May God bless each one of you for your generosity and bless the generosity of those that are far from here. The choir from the Chukuni Men's Center and from Monze. We thank you for launching our album, Jubilee, for putting in a lot of valuable time to reflect and work on the album. Thank you, you made this Jubilee celebration prayerful and joyful. Thank you very much. To the committee, the organizing committee and all the other committees who were involved in the planning and the work that led to the build-up of this event. Thank you very much. This celebration would not have been this way without your contribution. And to everyone present, our gratitude goes to each one of you here for taking time from your busy schedules and coming to celebrate with us. We cannot take your sacrifice for granted. We thank you and want to assure you that you will always be in our prayers. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. So I wish each one of you got traveling messages when the time comes for you to go home. Thank you very much.